Good morning, everyone. We'll begin in a few minutes. Okay, we'll just wait for some people to come on. For a second. So I'm going to tell people that as you, for today, we just as an experiment, I'm going to get you to grab a couple of coins or something that you can just hold on to. I'm going to, with your fingertips. Okay. So a couple of small coins, two small pieces of paper. You can do it without, but it's a little bit more challenging when you actually have to hold something. So then your attention goes even more. And we're just going to do sort of part of the, an awareness of how important what we talked about last Thursday, which was limiting body movement, increasing body movement and limiting our arms, so or our upper body movement. So you'll need a couple of coins for today, or something that you can just grasp with your fingers. Okay. Let's just start waking up our body a little bit. So just reaching out, working a little bit of shoulder. So really holding your shoulders up, and that really works a little bit more extension on those shoulder joints. And going the other way. So again, just extending out, allowing your shoulders to come up first, and then hands come across. So this is a breath in. So it's not just a warm up, it also becomes part of your getting into the whole mindset of what we're doing here today.
put yourself in the environment for our class. Good, hands to your side. Okay, so just roll in your shoulders a little bit. Okay, good. So just holding your posture, find your base. Doesn't matter which side, because you're going to work both sides anyways. So start with one side, found your base, and then just lifting up your legs, working a little bit of an extension, and really try to keep your head in line so that you're not tilting. So keeping your hips above your waist and really work a little bit of balance. If you find you're falling, try not to catch yourself. Just put yourself back down and then just restart. Or even just allow your toe just to make contact with the ground momentarily, just to find that place and then extend out. If you have a wall, sometimes just a little bit of a touch, just with your finger. And switch sides. So first find that base on your foot and then extend. Okay, so other side, this time working a forward motion, and it's like a bicycle. Think of like a bicycle kick, so you have that rotation, allowing the leg to come back a bit, so your knee is pivoting here on your hip, and just working that rotation on one side. Good, switch sides. So find your base, find your comfort, and extend. Good, and back down. So I asked if you can find two small coins. So if you can find a couple of small coins or just something that you can grasp with your hand just to hold on to just for a second while we go through part of our set. If you're not familiar with part one of the set, try to watch me and try to follow along as best you can. So even if it's some of the stationary movements, because you've never done this before, don't worry about it, right? So just try to follow along as best you can. So breathing in a few times. So with the coins, I want you to grab them between your thumb and any finger. Okay, so you can use two, however you feel more comfortable. I'm gonna use my thumb and my two fingers here. So the idea is neither you're squeezing them very tightly. Let's just do a couple of breaths. Just allowing them to stay between your fingertips. So what it does is it brings a little bit of awareness to that part of your body, only because you're supporting those coins or whatever you're holding. One more breath up. Okay. So let's start with our set. So starting to one side, shifting forward. Space, we're doing more of a shuffle step as opposed to actually walking. Now put the coins down. And let's just do the step one more time, only this time without it. So I want you to just feel the sense how different it feels when you're where you're where you bring your attention to. So if you're, this is how we were holding onto those coins, all our attention was really brought to our fingertips. And a lot of the body stuff sort of gets forgotten. And that's what tends to happen a lot of times when we do the step, is that we're always focusing on the hand that's moving, and we sort of sometimes neglect what really should be moving, right? So our shoulders and using body rotation and so on. So now that we've eliminated the support of those coins, let's try the set one more time. And again, those of you that are following, again, just try to watch, and then we'll do some more stationary stuff so that maybe more people can that aren't familiar with the set can participate as well. Okay, so let's take a few breaths. And go through the set. Attention tends to go more to your body. So whenever you're doing any part of the, whether it's Chi Sao or whether you're doing pushing hands, whatever you're doing, always try to bring that awareness to, don't necessarily always focus on the part that's moving the most as opposed to what's generating the movement. So just doing back from here, this motion here in part of the set, it's really starting from the shoulder first. So the awareness is, should not be on our hands. And that's what we're sort of guiding. It's really, it's starting from here first and it goes to our hands. So you figure the energy flows from here and flows down to and releases from our fingertips. So it's kind of a concept that I've always tried to sort of really stress sometimes, because you, when you're initiating the movements, you don't want them to be just this and wasted a lot of energy which could be generated from our body. So just putting, let's just work, same kind of concept. So let's put one side forward. So I have my left leg forward. And put our left hand up in a horizontal line. Vertical is our right. So our finger, this faces up, and this is facing to in my right. Okay, because I have my left hand up. So you're going to push forward, reaching. Pull back, rotate, and release. Once more. Actually, it's to push. So once more. T push. Gather. Before. Release. So think of it, this is now, if your fingertips are closed, you don't necessarily need the coin. Just kind of focus on your fingertips. So starting again. T push. Bring towards you, rotate, and release. Just feel that sense of difference that it makes when I'm now focusing on keeping my fingertips together. So where's my thought? Where's my focus? You may even feel, I know sometimes I do, I don't feel the same fluidity in my motion. So now let's open our hands and try the same thing. Okay. Release. And push. Switch sides. So right side forward. Right hand is up. Push. Gather. More. Deep push. Gather. And release. So I'm just going to go sideways. So keep your right side forward. So I have my right hand is up. Actually, I'll switch sides so it's easier for you to see. My left hand is up. You can stay with your right side, whichever way is more comfortable for you. So we're going to do that deep push. So as I shift forward, try not to allow your body to slouch forward. So you want to keep your shoulders above your hips. So I'm moving. Rotate, bring it back to the front, and then release. So important part of this is, again, where am I bringing my attention to? Is it in my fingertips, in my hands, or is it my whole body? So I can do this whole motion, just rocking back and forth, feeling that weight transfer as I go from forward to back. As I turn, weight is on my back foot, so it allows my lead foot to pivot. Come forward, it still needs to pivot, so the weight is still sort of in the back leg, and then coming forward. Well, what happens is when we start to integrate other body parts, so using our hands, we want to be careful that we don't get too focused on one and neglect the other. So here, with the T-push, and rotate, release, and push. Now let's bring in our breath. So again, we don't want to get too caught up on one particular part. So really try to minimize the thought for one particular thing. So you want to sort of balance everything out. So I'm balancing on how much focus I have on what my hip, where my weight is, my rotation, what my arms are doing. And now we're going to include our breath. So when we start from here, when I'm pushing out, like this would be, let's say, a breath out. As I'm coming in towards me, could be a breath in, a rotate. So that's my transition point. So you're not really holding your breath. You have that breath in, breath out, just starting to happen. And release. I call it breath overlap. So breath in. Release. Overlap. Release. Breath in. Overlap. And out. So if you go too quickly, you'll find that if you're really breaking down the section of the heart sequence with incorporating your breath, what happens is that if you're going too quickly through the step, then your breath is too quickly, and you might feel uncomfortable. So, for example, if I'm doing something like this, I'm just to be a breath in, transition, breath out. So my pace would be, and I might be too fast, right? So allow your breath to dictate how fast you do your set, and your set is also going to dictate how fast you breathe. So the two work in conjunction together. So starting again, T push. So breath in, overlap, and release. Breath in, overlap, and release. So doing it that way, working on your own for a few minutes, and just try to find where your breath feels a little bit, where you feel comfortable with your own pace, so you're not following my breath pace. And optimally, you may want to, for real, more of a meditative sort of movement through the heart sequence, you may want to sort of really slow it down. So now you have to focus on, you're controlling how much breath in and breath out. So you're sort of pinching the airways a little bit so that you're not, it's easy. I find it easier to take a breath in slowly. I find it sometimes a little bit more challenging to breathe out at the same pace. So you have that nice breath in. So you really want to work the two together, but then don't forget the point in between, right? So there has to be that sort of a minute where the air going in has a sort of momentum. And that momentum going in still is going to be happening. But you're also going now to start exhaling. So you have both things happening at the same time. So you have breath going in, breath going out, and that's where I call overlap. I use the term overlap because the two things are happening kind of at the same time. If you break everything off, like breath in, stop, hold, breath out, then what happens is it becomes very uncomfortable and it's not a normal breathing pattern, right? You always want things to be very loose and fluid with a lot of fluidity, and your movements will reflect your breath as well. So going back to our heart sequence, so I'm putting my, I can put my left side forward, just so you, again, for visual. And just work a few of those on your own for a second. It's incredible how quickly time goes by. If you have any questions, please use the chat area. He's joining us this morning. So let's just finish off. Let's go through our set. If you're not familiar with the set, then just work the heart sequence. You know, it's Tai Chi is so many things, and it's different things to different people. So wherever you're at the point, I mean, even just standing here and just sort of just working a breath in and a breath out, whatever you feel like doing for today. But if you want, you can also work that heart sequence. I'll just quickly. If there's anyone new, push with a T push. So my hands are facing, one is level, one is facing up. Push, bring towards me, rotate, and then release. And a push and start again. But the rest of us, let's just go through part one of the set. Work at your own pace. Don't worry about what's on the screen. And you're in your own element, find your own breath. And really just work that focus to try to balance everything out. So not one aspect of your Tai Chi is getting the majority of your vision or your thought. So really try to find that balance, I suppose. When I think of balance, I always think it's either one or the other. That's just my own thing. I gotta come up with something where it's more unified throughout, because there's so many different things between your breath, your weight transfer, your movements, and so on. So just do work through your at your own pace for just part one of the set. Thank you. just ignore me. I'm just gonna do a few breaths in. Well, I'm glad we had an opportunity to spend some more time together. This is certainly different, that's for sure. I miss you all in class. Hopefully we'll be back together soon. If you have any comments, I'll still be on for a little bit. If you have any questions, I'll use the chat line and I'll stick around for a little bit for you. If not, have a great day and as always, be safe. Okay, great. You guys all have a good day too. Thank you. Okay. All right, everyone. Take care. Thank you.